بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأصلي وأسلم على حبيبه وخير خلقه ومصطفاه من عباده محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم أما بعد All praise to be due to Allah سبحانه وتعالى The one who had created, the one who had invented, the one who keep giving substance, the one who keep giving us health, the one who gave us our eyes, and the one who had sent us Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the mercy, with the religion, and with the book. No one shall go astray from this book and from the example of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam unless someone has actually gone astray and went his life in vain. Brothers, what prompted me to come and talk to you tonight is a Muslim brother, a young man, a good, nice man, I like him. He said, I have a little problem. You know, I come to the mosque, I keep my salah, I love Allah, I love my family, I am going to do everything nice, but I have little problem. I tell him, brother, don't speak more. I know what problem you have. Well, this is an epidemic that is actually affecting our youth, affecting our young people, affecting old people. This is something that is actually reminding me of something when I was in China. You see, how come 200,000 soldiers of the British Empire control the China Empire, the Indian continent, and the all of Asian subcontinent and the Arabian countries? How could they do that for over 100 years? The answer was opium. Opium was a drug. They let it everywhere, from Vietnam to China to India, and they controlled, this empire controlled the people of Asia for over 100 years. Now, there is another drug, and this drug, actually, it's an epidemic. It's destroying us without knowing it, brothers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in his book, in chapter النور, the light, in verse number 30. قُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ غُضُّوا مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ. Tell to the believer of the men to lower their gaze. وَيَحْفَظُوا فُرُوجَهُمْ, and to protect their private parts. ذَلِكَ أَزْكَى لَهُمْ, this is more purer for them. إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا يَصْنَعُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is well acquainted and He knows what they are doing. And in the next verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked to the believer woman to also lower their gaze and to protect their private parts and to protect their adornment, their beauty, except whatever is aberrant, like the hands, the palm of the hands, or like the eyes, and should not show their beauty and adornment except to their husbands or fathers or husband fathers, and the whole category, you can check it out. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent us this Quran because of to teach us what is going to protect us in our life. The pornography, the epidemic of pornography, subhanAllah, has become so worldwide that I read a story in Melbourne, it happened. The story happened is what? Is a girl, they told her, they seduced her with money. They gave her $10,000 to go and make a movie for 15 minutes. $10,000 for 15 minutes, that's big money. And she make the movie. She took off her clothes. After that, she feel this is wrong. People tell her this is wrong, you have ruined yourself. She took back the money to the director. She tell him, I am giving you back $10,000. Please destroy the image of my movie. He says, no. The $10,000 I pay you, somebody already pay me $1 million. Who is these people who are paying $1 million? And putting pornography for free. 4,200,000 website of pornography for free, costing millions and trillions and billions of dollars to destroy you and you and you and me and every youth in our society. Brothers, let me remind you, 1957, USA, the Catholic Church was so strong, no obscenity picture is allowed to put on TV. Nothing is bad to put on TV, except one director, an Israeli director. He came, he make a movie about the Holocaust, and he show a woman. He show a woman figure, and then they said, I have to show it. This is the Holocaust. We have suffered as Jews. Okay, okay, put it. In 7 years, all the TVs in America full of pornography. Brother, if the children cannot stop, can you take them out, please? Jazakallah khair. You can take them out. Jazakallah khair. Now, what I want to say, brothers, it is not today this thing. They have actually destroyed Christianity in America and all their morality and all their innocence. And they have destroyed Catholicism, which was very strong religion there. They have destroyed it. And now they are coming after Islam. 400 million pages on the 400 million pages are coming to get our children and the children and the children just to destroy our morality and akhlaq. Brothers, we are going to tell you now what is the effect of pornography nudity on our brains. It is actually it released the same chemicals which released by hardcore drugs. When people sniff drugs, cocaine and heroin, that is the same chemicals that come to our mind when anyone see this kind of pictures. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. And I told my brother who asked me the question, brother, you are going to destroy your eyes. You are going to destroy your brain. It will become slow and you will become stupid. Your memory will lose. All this is effect is studies that has been actually in effect. Actually, Australian government came to the Muslim centers asking them, can you help us in this kind of study? Catholic priests coming to the Muslims, can you help us in this? We cannot fight it. We have already lost the war. They came to the Sheikh Abu Ayman asking him, can you help us in this? Because they understand the effect of pornography on the youth. It is destroying the culture, destroying the akhlaq. People are feeling now, it's out of akhlaq, whatever they see on TV, on internet, this is what actually is happening. So I want to tell you, brothers, some people would say that this is a small thing, but let me tell you from the studies what they discovered. They discover when the man starts to see after a few seconds what will happen to his brain. The cells in his brain will start burning. His brain will start giving chemicals which actually when people sniff the hardcore drugs, it will cause weakness in the memory. It will cause weakness in the eyesight. It will cause the very harmful effect on the immunity system. You see, our body does actually give good, strong immunity to any disease. It will make the immunity system weak. It will make the people who is young look very old, very early. It will make them less of the people who actually have irada. You know what is irada? Irada, which means resistance or insistence or actually even decision making. It will destroy, make the mind so slow and so weak, It will make the whole body actually collapse. It will destroy the people who is studying. It will destroy the sexual ability of any person, and thus will destroy his relation with his wife. Imagine now, somebody who is watching this all the time and he has this epidemic and he cannot do his duty to his wife, and he's all the time on the front of the internet watching. Why does his wife need him? Should he blame his wife when his wife tell him, I'm gonna divorce you, I don't want you anymore? Of course, because he's not a man, he's not doing his duty, he's becoming stupid. So his wife doesn't need him. She needs a real man to stand with her. These people feel that this thing is actually enjoyment, it's actually burning their brain. Brothers, this will make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He asks us, are you going to take the khabith and give the tayyib? Which means, are you going, people, to take the bad things and give up what is good thing? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you a good wife, a good family, a good children. And you leave all this and you start watching the public toilets of the society. The most people corrupted and have disease. Why? Because that is how much money they're spending on it. Millions and trillions and trillions. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given halal, tayyib, but the people actually go and destroy themselves. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has told us, Al-aynu tazni wa zinaha an-nazar. Even the eye can make adultery. Even the eye can make fornication. And its fornication is to look at the haram. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has told us that if we follow up the shaitan way, it will never stop us somewhere. I will tell you a story of a young man in an Arab country. You see, when people watching haram, this actually destroys them, and because they are earning sin. But can the man earn sin after he die from the pornography? Yes, he can. Some of you brothers, I told you the story. The story is a young man who started watching nudity little bit and shy, and after that this brother, he started to see more and more movie. This become an epidemic. This he become for him something he has to do every day, until he actually subscribed to a pornographic site to send him special pictures. This boy, he think he was doing something special. He starts sending samples to his friend, Muslim friends. His Muslim friend feel, wow, this is fantastic things. Can you send us more? He says, no, I pay money for it. I subscribe. You pay me money and I shall forward it to you automatically from my email. They pay him the money. And this, whenever an email come to him of this pornographic site, it goes to his friends. This young man had an accident and died. His friends sent him to the graveyard. They were crying, such a young man died at such young age. And they go home 3-4 days later. The emails still coming from his dead friend in his graveyard, still coming to them for the bad pictures. They sent to the company, please, this man is dead. Stop it. Stop it, we don't want this anymore. The company say, can you give us the password? They said, we can't give you the password, the man is dead already. They tell him, in this case, we'll still keep giving for you this picture for the next 5 years. Brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want us and remind us and send us warning. We need to stop. If someone is doing this bad thing, he need to stop. This is going to destroy your Islamic ummah. And this is going, as it has destroyed other ummah. I will tell you a story from my own country, Palestine, brothers. 2002, the Palestinian people refused to actually give up the rights of return to Palestine. So the Israeli army, as a punishment for them, they invade Ramallah. You know, the city beside Jerusalem. After they invade Ramallah, the Israeli army with their might, tanks, they issue an order, anybody walking on the street or show his head from the balcony will be shot. You have all of you to stay at home. So people are looking for the news, what's going on. They cannot go outside. Israeli army, in the same minute, they control the TV station all around Ramallah. And guess what they put in the movies there? All pornographic material for 2 months. The Palestinian in Ramallah couldn't know anything. If they have to open TV, it's a pornographic material. Why would an Israeli army want to give us freedom? You know, when you talk to someone, this is not akhlaq, this is something bad. You say, oh, are you against the freedom? Freedom of scripture and freedom of drawing and freedom of TV. This is not freedom, this is slavery. That's how they enslaved the Islamic Ummah. When I was in China, I was feeling difficult. How come 200,000 soldiers from the British Empire control 400 million Chinese, 400 million Indian, and another people in Asia? How could they do that? They use drugs, hardcore drugs, and they call it the opium war. The Chinese couldn't get out from this opium war fighting for 150 years. Opium was sold in the streets. This is reminding me what it was happening in Gaza before Hamas took over Gaza. You see, Muhammad Dahlan, who is a Palestinian working for the Jews, he was distributing, and this is my responsibility, I'm saying it, they were distributing hardcore drugs to the Palestinian schools under the influence of the Palestinian Authority. That's why the brothers in Hamas couldn't accept this anymore. They were actually trying to get any Palestinian girl to have drugs and use that girl with pornography and other materials in order to destroy more and more and more. This is what they use for Palestine, and Palestine, don't forget, is a sample for the whole of Islamic Ummah. What they are doing this to the whole of the Islamic Ummah, but we don't feel. We feel, oh, some young people feel, oh, so great. This pornographic site, very free. Wow, so big movies, so big names, and all is free. It is not free. This price for this pornographic is your soul. You sell your soul to the shaitan. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. When anybody opens this in his own home, this is the Israeli occupied territories in your own home. Again, I repeat, the Israeli occupied territories in your own home is the pornographic material that you opened. This fight has to come to the level that you understand. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has warned us about the shaitan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الشيطان يعدكم الفقر ويأمركم بالفحشاء. The shaitan will always tell you, you are poor, you don't have to pay money, okay? Use these things, pornographic sites, and use this kind of nudity pictures in order to release your pressure as a man. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promise us, if we are patient and we abide by His rule, that Allah will give us good wives, good family, good income. So what we choose, what Allah has promised or what the shaitan has promised? Brothers, this is not only the Israeli army and what they are doing it. And I will tell you now, the biggest movie making theater in the world of doing this kind of pornographic material, over 400 million page of pornographic material for free, over 4,200,000 sites, pornographic sites, to destroy our akhlaq and our youth. Who is paying all this money for? Hollywood is the biggest producer of this kind of movies. And the names of the Hollywood producers who is paying all this money and then put it all for free. It is not for free. It is to enslave the whole world and to enslave you Muslims. And I declare that Christianity in America has bowed down to them, and Catholicism has bowed down to them. The only remaining power, the only remaining in front of them is the true Muslims who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Takbir! True Muslims who lower their gaze when they see something haram. That is what they want to get you. That is how much they are trying to destroy you. When the American army invaded Iraq, brothers, imagine, they said they are coming for the oil. That's true. They did not bomb the oil ministry, but there is something else they did not. They bomb everywhere. Five-star hotels, bridges, schools, underground shelters, they bomb everything. I was following there. I was in Jordan that time. They bomb everywhere, except the Ministry of Oil and except the theaters. Why? Because they know what they want to put in the theaters. They know that it is very important. I am using a gun, but there is more powerful gun than this gun. What is that gun? To destroy inside our azima and our irada. And to bring us the wahan. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam talked to his friends, to his companions. تَتَدَاعَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْأُمَمْ كَمَا تَدَاعَتِ الْأَكَلَةُ عَلَى قَصَعَتِهَا. The whole of the world nations will come unto you like people who are coming to eat for their food. The Sahaba say, Ya Rasulullah, أَمِنْ قِلَّةٍ نَحْنُ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. Is it because we are little, few people? He say, no. لَا وَلَكِنَّكُمْ غُثَاءً كَغُثَاءِ السَّيْلِ. You are as much as the foam on the beginning of the sea, of the river. That is how much you are. They tell him, Ya Rasulullah. So what is it? He tell him, because you hated the death and you had the wahan in your chest. And this is exactly what I am causing the wahan in our chest, brother. This kind of movie, I call it the cause of the wahan. Why? Because people just looking for the pleasures of life. Not looking for the knowledge of science of dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is destroying them. It had destroyed nations before them, and they are coming to get the 1,000 million Muslims as well. I've been to Syria for the last 50 years, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has told us something, and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a sadiq. He said, Ala innal iman bisham, which means the belief, the true belief of religion is in Asham. For the last 50 years, Al-Assad regime was trying to break the people wahan. You go to Salah, you will go to jail. You go to Salat al-Fajr, you are already a criminal. You disappear. You want to go jihad against Israel, they disappear you. You are a Palestinian mujahid, will kill you. So many of the friends, I know them, they go from Arab country, Palestine, and they went to jihad in Lebanon. The Syrian regime destroyed them. But the Syrian regime was after something more powerful. Because the Syrian regime and the Zionism are one coin, two faces. They are actually destroying the akhlaq of Asham. You know, the Sham, the woman in Sham is so protective of her face, so protective of her honor and chastity, that nobody is allowed to touch her. They send an army in the street, any woman covering her head, to remove the veil from her head. And this caused a war in Hama. These people, the same people, they try every way possible to destroy the iman in Asham by using pornography, open pornography, free for the Syrian people. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they make makr, and Allah make makr, and Allah makr is the best of the makr. وَيَمْكُرُونَ وَيَمْكُرُ اللَّهُ وَاللَّهُ خَيْرُ الْمَاكِرِينَ. Now, the people who go fight, who make revolution in Syria, they never expected. You know, they were paying people, the Sunni people, $500, come and write your name as you are a Shia. Just take $500, just write your name and go. This is how much they wanted to destroy the akhlaq of the people and destroy the religion. And they know who is the truly people who will stand in their way. Brothers, not only happened this in Gaza, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us that they will be trying to destroy your iman and trying to make you pagans. They would prefer that you Muslims become pagans, not believer of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَوَ يَرُدُّونَكُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ إِيمَانِكُمْ كُفَّارًا حَسَدًا مِنْ عِنْدِ أَنفُسِهِمْ. Why? Because they have hasad and they have envy for every Muslim who make الشهادة أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله. Now we know the effect and we know who is the reason and we know, and I can tell you the names. I have been doing such a strong research that in America, brothers, subhanAllah, there are so many people, the people who are against these things. One of them is Dr. David Duke. He is fighting them, and you can watch all his on YouTube, you can watch all his talking. They always talk about him, he's a white supremacist, so that we don't listen to what he's talking about. He say that they have crippled America with this kind of things. And I would advise you to go to David Duke, Dr. David Duke, and see all what they are called, destroyed America, and how they are going to destroy the world. Not only they are using the pornography, now the Weinstein brothers, who are the biggest producers of movie in Hollywood. You know, Weinsteins, you would know what kind of people they are. Weinstein brothers. Not only they are using the pornography, they are using violence and pornography. They have made so much movies that now, in one of their movies, they had actually bashing people. And the people in America said, for us, this is like a sexual pleasure when they are bashing people by head and by destroying them. And one of the movies they done is Inglourious Basterds. And this is the people who is making this kind of things. Now, violence and also pornography. So they want to destroy not only the people, and they want to make that you are making violence against Muslims, that is something easy. And if the Muslims in Afghanistan, they said, if you are a Muslim, you don't go to the theater, then you will go to jail. If you go to the mosque. Many things, subhanAllah, when I'm starting to study about this, it drives me, subhanAllah, nuts how these people is doing and how much money they are paying in the world. But if we understand, brothers, it is also affecting us on the personal. I will show you one man, actually, who think that this watching this kind of things is small thing, it's not a big problem, it's for him private, he's not doing something wrong, nobody is being hurt. One day, his daughter, less than 3 years old, she came to him while he's watching. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ She tell him, Baba, let's play. No, go away, don't come near me. She come to him, she is a small child, Baba, please, come play with me. She's alone at home. No, go away, go play by yourself. And he let the girl go play by herself. The girl, she play by herself, and then he finished seeing the movie. He go to his daughter. Okay, Baba, you finish playing? Get up now. He see his daughter sleeping. The daughter is not waking up. Baba, wake up. There is no breath for the girl. The girl breath is out. Baba, what's happened? What's wrong? Baba. The girl has died. She had choked on a small toy, and while she was actually suffering and being killed, dying, he was watching this kind of things. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ How many father and how many mother destroy their relation with their children? Instead of taking their children outside, they destroy their families. Wallahi, brothers, some sisters come to us crying. Our husbands don't come sit with us. They are always in front of the computer watching this kind of things. We tell them, astaghfirullah, make your salah. Then what we can do? وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ This is destroying families. And anyone who is doing this and don't know how to get rid of it, brothers, the time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has reminded you. One brother came to me and he said the other day he received a message. So he was reluctant to open it. But the picture was really attractive. He watched it and he said in the morning when he urinated blood. I tell him, brother, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He loves someone, He give you a reminder. He gave you a reminder, blood. Next time it might not be blood, it might be your life. Never ever allow yourself to let your eyes come and see bad things. I compare a man who have died watching this pornography and sending it to his friend, and I compare it with a man in the same country, in the Arab country, was reciting in Salatul Maghrib, وَاصْبِرْ نَفْسَكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَدَاتِ وَالْعَشِيِّ. He was reciting, he was the imam, steadfast with those people who supplicate to Allah morning and evening. وَلَا تَعْدُ عَيْنَاكَ عَنْهُمْ. Do not let your eyes stay away from them. Stick your eyes with these people. Stick your eyes with the jama'ah. وَلَا تَعْدُ عَيْنَاكَ عَنْهُمْ. وَلَا تُطِعْ مَنْ أَغْفَلْنَا قَلْبَهُ عَنْ ذِكْرِنَا. And don't follow those whom we have left apart our dhikr. Those who are zalimun. While he's reading this ayah, he stopped. The people in the first row started reminding him, telling him, تُرِيدُ زِينَةَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. جزاك الله خير. As the brother said, تُرِيدُ زِينَةَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. But the Shaykh is not repeating this ayah. تُرِيدُ زِينَةَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. The Shaykh is shaking, and the Shaykh fall down. And when he fall down, the people catch him. And what he's doing? He's doing shahada, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. This is the people you should keep your eyes on. Your own jama'ah, your own family, your own friends. And you should advise people that this people is coming to get you and coming to destroy you. And this is the Israeli occupied territories in your own home. Why would you allow your own home to have an Israeli occupied territories, brother? This Sheikh died while repeating to the people, stick your eyes to those people who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell us that sometime he send us a reminder from our own family. A little girl came to her father and she saw him watching this kind of thing. A little girl. And she tell him, Baba, ittaqillah. Ittaqillah, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What we will say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when we allow ourselves, our eyes that Allah has given us as the best of the things He has given us as gift to use it for haram. My brothers, it is important to know that people will be resurrected how they die. If you died while you are reciting Quran, you will be resurrected on the day of Qiyamah reading Quran. If you resurrected doing haram, you will be resurrected doing haram. How many of you seen the Italy city, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed the city by volcano from the mountain and from the floods from the sea, and their bodies are preserved as it is, as they have actually died. Have you seen this in Italy? You have seen it, brothers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can do everything. So we should not go and challenge Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by doing ma'asiyah. This is not a small ma'asiyah. This is a big ma'asiyah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want us to be of those who preach kindness, purity, sincerity, innocence, chastity. We, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, want to remind us. And not only that. Now, the West themselves, if they look at the Muslim woman, don't they see the same picture? She is covering herself as Virgin Mary covered herself. This is the chastity, the purity, and the innocence. Don't they see the man, the Muslim man, he is actually wearing the clothes that does not show his body? Is the purity of Islam is we are following Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we are following also the teaching of Sayyidina Isa, Jesus. So, brothers and sisters, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sitting in the mosque, a man came, as it seems he come from very far away travel. He is so much black hair, so much white clothes. He is coming from a far away travel, but he does not look as he came from a far away travel. He came to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, He put his hands to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam hands. He put his knees to his knees. Look how important. And he sit and he ask him, Ya Muhammad, mal Islam? Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam tell him, Al-Islam an tashhad an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammad Rasulullah. Ya Muhammad, what is Iman? What is belief? أن تؤمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه. You believe in Allah and His Messenger and His books and His angels. And he said, yes, correct. And he tell him, Ya Muhammad, ما الإحسان? What is the goodness? Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم says, الإحسان أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك. The goodness is that you worship Allah as if you are seeing Him. And if you are not seeing him, you know that he is seeing you. This is ihsan. This is how a Muslim fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When a people sitting by themselves in the corner of a home, that is not the correct way that the internet should be done. The internet should be in the middle of the home where everybody can see. That is the place. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching over us. Even if no one sees us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching us. They told me, a Yemeni brother who used to live in New York, from a poor family, he went to New York, he started working there in the kitchen hand. But this boy, he always had one good akhlaq. He always lowered his gaze to the floor. Whenever he sees a woman, he lower his gaze. That is how the way he is. One day he come out in the left, going to his company. A woman, so beautiful, looks so rich, so strong perfume, stand beside him. He lower his gaze. The woman tell him, why don't you look at me? He say, I can't look because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ask us, lower your gaze. She said, am I not beautiful? He said, wallahi, I see you. You are look very beautiful, but I can't see you anymore. That's it. The woman started to ask him, what is this religion that actually stop you so strong to look at something pleasurable? He started to explain to her about Islam. This woman was the owner of the company. And after that, she entered Islam and she married him. Brother and sister, you have to understand. When you give up something for Allah, Allah will reward you something better than it. When you give up something for Allah, you should make sure that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to give you something better than it. Don't think that I'm giving a pleasure and this is something that people enjoy it. No, you are giving it for the most kind, and Allah is the most kind, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you. Will reward you strength with your wife. Will reward you respect with your wife. Will reward you respect with your children. This, what a reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you when you lower your gaze, when you protect yourself, when you protect your private parts. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, ما تركت بعدي فتنة أضر على الرجال من النساء. Nothing is more harmful, more severe, more difficult for the men of my ummah more than the fitna of nisa. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, اتقوا النساء. Be careful to mix with the woman, except your own wife. Be careful to mix with them. فَإِنَّ أَوَّلَ فِتْنَةِ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ كَانَتْ فِي النِّسَاءِ. Bani Israel, whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Al-Maghdubi alayhim, in the Quran, their fitna started with the woman. So would we give up what Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has told us and has teach us? Brothers, so many people actually has given up watching this thing and go back to their senses and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness. I know quite a few, actually, when they give up these things, their relation with their wife becomes so good. His wife respect him so much because he's a man. He's a man everywhere. Outside the home, inside the home, everywhere, he's a man. He's proven himself. And he gives to his wife what she needs and what she deserves. So his wife always take care of him. Unlike those people who destroy their power by watching something haram. So, how can we, brothers, actually go and stop these things? First of all, of course, when you do something in the, subhanAllah, look these numbers. You put these numbers on your properties, you know, in every computer at your home, because you don't know, sometimes if the kids is watching the internet and you are not at home, you are not in control. If you have these numbers, these properties, and I have tried it, alhamdulillah, you put this number on the properties in the protocol number 4, and you add it in the down the box, you add these numbers that is here, and no pornographic picture will come to your computer or any computer that is touched by your home. Nothing. It will stop it, cripple it 100%. Not only that, there are so much ways to censor, and you can go to the internet on YouTube as well, and you can check it out. How to control, and from the source. Now your home is free from this kind of Israeli-occupied territories. So, number 2, we should think and we should stick with the jama'ah. Stick to the masjid. If someone is away and he's not appearing, we have to call him, brother, how are you? What's going on with you? Because the shaitan is like the wolf. He will only take the sheep that is far away. You want to ask a question? Which one? The numbers? Jazakallah. Okay. Ahsan, barakallah feek. Ahsan, this is the number. Is it clear? This is, you go to the properties, and from the properties, brothers, you can find it, inshallah. Now, another thing that we need to do, that we need to know, that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, بَشِّرِ الزَّانِي بِالْفَقْرِ وَلَوْ بَعْدَ حِينَ. Anyone who makes zina, zina with eyes, or zina the fornication, anyone who do it, he will become poor, sooner or later. So if you do not stop, you should know that you will become poor. You will lose your money. You will lose your power. You will lose your family. You will lose your children. And something else, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has told us, يَا مَعْشَرَ الشَّبَابِ مَنْ اسْتَطَاعَ مِنْكُمُ الْبَاءَةَ فَلْيَتَزَوَّجْ. O young man, O youth, whomever can get married, let him to get married. It is very important, brothers. And this is getting married and taking care of the wife. The Muslim, good woman, will protect you and will help you and will stop the door of the shaitan to come to you. Brothers, how many of you here practice martial arts, boxing? You practice martial arts long time before? Anybody, young people, you practice young? Yeah? So when you practice this, do you feel that every day somebody will come and you will fight him? No. He might come, he might never come. But this kind of pornography, this kind of danger is so important that we should be prepared, and we should be prepared to fight it. And how to fight it? Fight it with the jama'ah. Fight it with the nasiha. الدين النصيحة. قالوا لمن يا رسول الله قال لله ولرسوله والمؤمنين. Your religion is the advice. Islam is the advice. To who? To Allah, to His Messenger, and to the believers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So brothers, we have to understand. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكًا. Whomever stay away from my remembrance because of this or this or pornography or other things. وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكًا. He shall have a hardship life. وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى. And on the day of judgment, we will resurrect him blind. The man will be resurrected blind and he will talk to Allah, Ya Rabb. قَالَ رَبِّ لِمَ حَشَرْتَنِي أَعْمَى. Ya Rabb, why you resurrected me blind? Why? قَالَ كَذَلِكَ أَتَتْكَ آيَاتُنَا فَنَسِيتَهَا فَكَذَلِكَ الْيَوْمَ تُنْسَى. Such as my signs has come to you, my warning has come to you, and you choose to forget it. You choose to go to watch pornography and nudity and bad things. You choose to stay away from my remembrance. And today you shall be forgotten on the day of judgment. Brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us this great gift from Him, the eyes. We should not use it for haram. Otherwise, wallahi, we will lose it. And we will lose it and we will cry for it. And after we lose it, we will lose our memory, our body, and our strength. and our wives and our money and our wealth and our children. And the wahan will come to us. What is the wahan? The wahan is loving the enjoyment of the dunya. Brothers, this subject, subhanAllah, is so important that we need to actually think about it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, on the day of judgment, I want to tell you how important these eyes, which we actually love to see Allah with it. On the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come to the people of Jannah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask the people of Jannah, would you like me to increase you something more? Ya Rab, so beautiful the Jannah. Our house is one brick of gold, one big brick of silver. There are rivers beneath us. All these gardens, whatever we wish it come to us, what more? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to them that today you can see me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take the hijab and we can see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma ja'alna mimman narahu Allah rabbul alameen. Allahumma ameen. Allahumma ja'alna mimman yadkhuluna al-firdaws al-a'la min al-jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will let them see him with their eyes. And this will be the greatest gift, the greatest happiness that the people of Jannah would have. So why would we go and destroy this great gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the eyes that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given it to us? Brothers, this matter not only is destroyed countries and they are trying to destroy the nations, it is coming to get every one of us. It is so easy, but yet we can easily to fight it. Stick with the jama'ah, stop the source of pornography and declare war on it. Wallahi brothers, there are so many people who are not Muslim who will enter Islam if we tell them what Islam says and how we Islam behave, let us behave in front of this, because many of them are facing this difficulty and they do not know how to solve it. So I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring us back to our religion. اللهم ردنا إلى ديننا ردا جميلا يا رب العالمين. اللهم رد شباب الأمة إلى دينهم ردا جميلا يا رب العالمين. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها. اللهم زكها أنت خير من زكاها. اللهم اجعلنا يا رب العالمين من عبادك الصالحين. اللهم اجعل خير أعمالنا خواتيمها وخير أيامنا يوم لقائك وارفع مقتك وغضبك عنا. Oh Allah, destroy those who want to destroy humanity and those who want to destroy the sincerity and the innocence of the people. Oh Allah, give them disease more harsh than AIDS. Oh Allah, destroy their houses. Oh Allah, show us with them. Those people who intend to destroy the humanity and destroy the religion. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, show us in them your ayat and destroy them with a disease they can never cure. Allahumma ameen. Brothers, jazakumullah khair. Yani, subject is so long, and I want you to do other things, but if you have any questions, I'm inshallah ready to answer you. Any questions? Yes, brother. Question? Na'am, akhi. You can put it in anywhere you can have the properties, yes, even the iPad. But if you have it at home, you can actually stop the whole home from having it, because this is the Wi-Fi. This is the wireless. The Wi-Fi. Yes, brother?
It's in the modem, yes.
It's in the modem. So you are an engineer, computer engineer? No. Yes? So you want to tell us how to go through this?
Yes.
Come, please. Please come help us. You're not shy. Come, yeah. Come, please. Tell us, we'll go to the properties, yes. Tell us how to do it, as you are an engineer. Yes.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Just you have to go through your modem, Wi-Fi modem or the internet modem at the home. You can access it with the modem. Every modem has its unique address. Generally, it's on the box, or you can Google it, which model your modem is. They will give you an IP address. If you enter that IP address in the web page, it will open your modem site instructions. There you can put these things, properties, you can control everything. you can put parental controls, what your child can do and cannot do, which sites you can block and all those stuff you can access from there.
Any other question? So, brothers, actually, I didn't know about this, but I went to the internet, to the YouTube, and I write block pornography, just block pornography. And they teach you step by step what to do on your computer. Even for people who cannot, not good in computers, they take you 3 steps, and then you can put these numbers, and the whole Wi-Fi system, it will be blocked. No more pictures will come to the home, no more nonsense, no more spam, inshallah. Jazakumullah khair. Any other questions, brother? Yes? Ahsantum? Jazakumullah khair. Yes, brother?
The brother asked me about the acceptance of gazing.
Acceptance of?
Exceptions for gazing. Like, for example, if acquiring an education and going to a doctor and so forth, then it's sort of warned me to explain a bit more on the exceptions.
Exception of gazing, you are talking to have more than one look? Is that correct? So if the doctor is a lady doctor, can you talk to her? Can you look at her? Something like that?
Yeah. Like when it comes to dealing and so forth.
Well, brother, as it's been said, the first look is for you. The second look is against you. Which means is, if at times the doctor is showing you something you have to look at, you look at. But if the doctor or even a sister, okay, or even someone in the street come talk to you and you feel you don't have to look at the sister, you can actually look at the floor. You can look at the floor while you are talking to them. And this way, because this is the taqwa in your heart, is the any look, because the look is the siham of Iblis, you know? The siham of Iblis is the look. So we should not accept a second look. That is a woman talking to us, that is not our wife, we cannot look at them, our wife, our mother, we should look at the floor. Do not look at them, except if they tell you, okay, look here or look there. Otherwise, you try to lower your gaze, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says.
Same with the teacher, like gazing something.
Same with the teacher, of course, same with the teacher. You don't have to look at the teacher, look at the board. You don't have to look at the big teacher face to face, because this looking at the teacher actually will break. If the teacher is young, this will create in your mind something, oh, this is a young lady, not married, maybe, oh, I can marry her. Or maybe the shaitan, this is the shaitan way. So if you have to explain to them, as a Muslim, I cannot look to you directly. So, but I'm going to look at the board. You try to make your face, always your eyes, not to concentrate. Stay away from woman, brother. Look at the woman, this is very dangerous. It's actually destroying many, many nations. Jazakallah khair. Any questions, brother? Jazakumullah khair. Yes, Habib.
In Western culture, they talk about eye contact as being part of communication. How do you talk to them or to explain out of that?
Well, if he is a man, a true man, I would look at him eye to eye and I would talk to him eye to eye. If she is a lady, maybe a teacher, maybe a professor, maybe a doctor, we have to tell them, excuse me, lady, my sister, excuse me, I cannot look at you face to face because this is my religion. So I'm going to look on the, I'm going to curve my head and look on the other side, but I'm listening to you carefully. Why? Because this is my religion. This is a way of da'wah. As I told you, some woman will be accepting. How a man can control himself, not look at a woman? Because it's our religion. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly has mentioned to us in this surah, قُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَغُضُّوا مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ. You are a believer in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, lower your gaze. وَيَحْفَظُوا فُرُوجَهُمْ. That is the second one. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made one of the highest standards, وَالْحَافِظِينَ فُرُوجَهُمْ وَالْحَافِظَاتِ. Those who protect their private parts among the men, and those who protect their private parts among the women. Among the highest of the standards of the religion. So how to protect? The first sin is the look. That's why you stop the first sin. Look at the floor, ask them, sorry, I cannot look at you directly, I'm going to look at the other side. Even she look at you, This will be really, if Muslim men do this, wallahi, many women will become believer of Islam. Many women. Because everyone is looking to them with lust. Except you as a Muslim man, you're looking at the floor. Why? You are not a man? You are a very strong man. But why? Because I afraid Allah, I'm looking at the floor. So if the problem is akhlaq al-Muslimin before, Indonesia, the largest country in the Muslim country, they all became, after they see the akhlaq of Muslims. You think the merchants who came to Indonesia first time, they were looking at the woman like that? Of course not. They were looking at the floor. Yes, sister, take what you want and go. That is the akhlaq of Islam. قُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَغُضُّوا مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ. Lower your gaze. That is the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Any questions? Jazakumullah khair. Khair, inshallah, we conclude this tonight. Jazakumullah khair. Subhanakallahumma wa hamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. And inshallah, till next week, inshallah, jazakumullah khair. And thank you very much for your tonight, inshallah, action. Thank you, brother, for helping us. Jazakumullah khair. And we need to teach each other. And whatever we learn today, we tell it to others. So everyone, inshallah, will stop this kind of Israeli occupied territories at home. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.